I'm Liam.
And I'm Finn.
And that's a lion.
Liam B. Finn News.
Show you the route that we're doing today. So we slept at Malelane last night, and then Liam forgot his phone and his flip-flop, and his flip-flops up at Biamiti where we stayed the night before. So we drove up this side over here, and then we drove up here along past Biamiti, and then we're probably going to come down this road or the tar road over here back to Malelane.
Okay, so this is the hide that we're in right now. If you come inside, you can see they've been taking some pictures. And yeah, this is where we are right now. There's a riverbed down there, so that's pretty nice.
So right now we're doing a self-drive where you drive your own vehicles and look for your animals by yourself. But you can also go on a game drive on a game vehicle where you get someone who has a lot of knowledge about animals and nature and stuff so that they can show you and find all the animals. So if you come to the Kruger Park, there's a few ways that you can sleep, or there's a few different types of accommodation. You can either do camping, where you bring your tent and you set it up and you bring your own food, or you can stay in little rondavels or small rooms like what we're doing, where you also bring your own food, or you can stay in a more fancy place where it's like very posh and you can get food given to you.
Then we went up the H4 to up the H41, then across to Skukuza, and then we came down on the tar road all the way to our camp, which was Malelane.
Ooh, look at that.
So we bought lots of snacks for the road.
Liam,
hey guys.
Ooh, a nice lot of snacks for the road. Okay, right now we're on a bridge that goes over the Biamiti River, and we're about to go to the Afstel trading post, which has a little coffee shop and picnic site. So we're just heading back to martial eagle eating a warthog.
Eating a baby warthog.
So we just arrived back at the Malelane Camp and we're going to go show you guys where we're staying and some stuff. Yeah. Okay, so the Malelane Camp, it's kind of at the right at the bottom of the Kruger National Park. So there's, that's like the boundary there. There's just a river down there and then that's the edge of the Kruger National Park. Most of the camps are like inside, so it's just like wilderness surrounding you, but this is nice. It has like this nice lawn, some baobab trees, and the gate's over there if you want to go out to go find some more stuff. And we have this little outdoor area over here. The chairs are all up, I don't know why, so that stuff doesn't fall on them or something. And yeah, we, here's our little rendezvous over here, number 3 that we're staying at. So yeah, and it sleeps 4 people and there's a bathroom. And there's a little kitchen inside our house, but not that big. I'll show you just now. So if you do want to go do washing or anything, you just gotta go to one of those 2 buildings, and because there's sinks and things there. Okay, so we thought we'd give you a little bit more detail tour of the house in case anyone wants to come stay here, or if they want to, I don't know, to know more about the place that we're staying. So outside is a nice stacked place with the table and chairs here for you to have dinner or something, because there's no table chairs inside. And there's no light here, which is kind of annoying, but still fine. Then there's this, you can just bring your own light. There's a bra here if you want to cook any food or anything. And then we'll take you inside. And yeah, so it has this front door over here which has a lock, and it has this mesh that insects can't get in, and then another door that has that's just a proper like barn door, and it also has a key so it can lock in case you're worried about that. Here's the light switch for I'm not sure which light that switch is for actually.
It's for this, that main one over there above the chair.
Okay, so and then those for the bathrooms. Okay, so then, so this is a 4-bedroom sleeper. I think there's only 4 bedrooms, 4 man
sleepers in here. Except for the maybe that big one down there.
Yeah, that big one, we're not sure about that one. And then in here there's a mini kitchen almost. There's a fridge and some appliances. Fridge, kettle, toaster. Did we bring that toaster?
No.
That's not. And a microwave. And we just bought our own coffee machine. There's this plug point here, and that's actually the only plug point in the whole house, in the whole room. And then up here, there's some stuff. All of this stuff basically was here when we came. There's pots, trays, utensils.
Everything was here when
we everything.
Came.
Yeah, everything. Yeah, mugs. And then each person has a bed. It has kind of these old, I don't know what they're called. They just like cover up the bed. But underneath there's a blanket and a sheet. And a fitted sheet as well. And then 2 pillows, and it comes with towels. And also those little Kruger things. Those Kruger stuff which are really nice.
Oh, yeah.
It's like my favorite thing. And then have side tables with drawers, and then this aircon is so nice because at the last place we were at, it was so hot, like unbearable. And then we come here and there's such a nice aircon, we were so happy. A nice big cupboard space. I won't open that because it's got a little bit close in it. And then this is the toilet inside here. There's basically this toilet, and then in the room next door over there, there's a shower and a sink. I'll show you that now. And it has a barn door over here. So I would say with this barn door, it's probably not that nice if you're not staying with family members or anything. And then this is a nice leather seat over here. Come here, and there's quite a few windows here. You can see 2, and then there's more smaller windows in the bathroom. All the beds have little mats here as well. And then if you come into this bathroom over here, there's a sink over there, windows, and there's a towel rack over here, and a small towel rack over here for probably hand towel or something, and quite a big shower. And yeah, that's about it. And then there's a few lights on each bed.
And there's also a nice mirror.
Yeah, there's quite a few spaces, quite a bit of space here for bags and stuff.
Yeah, it's quite a spacious room.
Yeah, I think it's quite spacious. And now we're gonna go start lunch, and we're making noodles.
Yeah, and we're gonna go make it in the communal area.
Yeah,
we'll and we can show you, yeah, and all the amenities there. Peace. Okay, got everything for the noodles. Let's go.
A success. I lit it.
Did you get it?
I lit it. Yeah.
Oh, I bought the flavor.
I just had to do it on this one. Wait, let's see if we can get this one started, because this one's better.
Ah.
Oh.
where do we
Why did you turn it off?
Keep going.
What is that? Yo. Okay, are we gonna move it across?
Oh no, it just died again. Just leave it.
Yeah, I think that was kind of sketchy. Okay. We thought that we would also like tell you guys a little bit about ourselves.
Yeah.
Because well, this is our first video.
Yeah.
So we're twins.
Yeah.
We live in South Africa.
Yeah.
In Durban.
Yeah.
And we're 14.
Yeah.
And yeah. We watched like a few like travel vloggers like In and Beck and King It and Van Life Sagas.
Yeah.
A lot of Van Life and Bus Life videos. And we love watching those videos. So we thought we'd try to do something like that.
Yeah. And now we're in the Kruger, we thought this is the perfect opportunity.
Yeah. And we're not gonna be like super serious about it, like uploading once a week or whatever. We're just gonna do it like whenever we feel like.
Yeah.
And see how many people like our videos.
So if you like it, give it a big
thumbs
up.
Give it a thumbs up or
subscribe
or like.
And this is the Kruger National Park Sighting 4 Malelane area. So what you do? Let's say, what do we see anything today? Ah, we saw rhino, but there's no rhino stickers. So if there was a rhino one.
We saw elephant as well.
Yeah. So if we saw a rhino one, when we saw rhinos, we can go put it where we saw it on the map.
And why did you point to it? Now the poachers are going to know, Liam.
Okay, don't look.
Okay, so my boy Finn. So my boyfriend got this bowl. As you can see, there's a bowl inside a
but I can't get it out.
Nice one.
Oh, it's so dusty down here.
Oh, the struggles. Come on. It's so slippery. I literally can't get it out.
Wait, I got it.
Night, night.
Morning.
Morning. Liam's in the back because it's my day today, which
and
means
today we're going to Pretoria School. Driving to Pretoria School. And yesterday.
We finished the game drive, then we stopped vlogging, then we went back to the house and we're just relaxing there. And then we went on like an evening drive to, what's that place called? Bergendahl.
We saw a
leopard just outside Bergendahl. And then, we also swam and had some sundowns. And then we went back, we had hamburgers for dinner. And then we went to sleep, and then we woke up.
The lady shut the
afternoon. And then before we left for the night drive, after we came back for the game drive, there was this lady.
We're climbing trees. We're climbing trees, and then this lady came and shouted us for climbing trees, and said she was going to call the park ranger.
Yeah, and she was calling trees. You guys like.
She was calling us and telling us to go back to the zoo.
We'll catch up when we see another animal on the game track.
Okay, now we're at Renostepan. We've just seen southern ground hornbills walking along the ground, which are big, very endangered birds. They almost look prehistoric, but it was a nice sighting, and you have to call it and tell the people who run the society trying to protect the ground hornbills, send them pictures so that they can use it for their data and all their information. Thank you.
Okay, so we just went to Pretoria's Cook, and there was a like a huge pool there that was like rock. We have a video of it, we can show you it. And we went there and we swam there. And then we've just made our way back to our camp, Malelane. But we haven't seen really any animals or anything.
But now we're just getting held up by a huge elephant.
Yeah, it has really big tusks. And it's raining now. We just went to Kruger Park again to go swim, and my mom went to go bird, and yeah.
And we on the afternoon drive now. We just left Kruger Park and we saw some hyena.
Yeah, one hyena that looked like it was dead. It was like sitting under a bush. You thought they were dead. Okay, so we came back to our camp after we went on our night drive. Well, not really a night drive, it was Kruger Day. Towards the night time, and then we came back just before the gate closed, and then we ate dinner, which was brisket. Like pork chop, like beef chops. What is it? Beef chops, lamb chops. And then after that, we're probably just going to eat chocolate and take 30 seconds.
Peace.
Okay, so we're leaving now Kruger National Park and going out Malelane Camp.
Yeah, and we just had breakfast, woke up, packed the car, and now we're on our way home. It's 9 hours home to Durban.
Bye.